It is deeply concerning to read news reports of acute shortages of medical equipment, hospital beds, etc. Reports from across the country also speak of the scarcity of COVID-19 vaccine as also of important life-saving drugs, including remdesivir, in different parts of the country. It is in these challenging and emergent times that we, the members of the Congress Working Committee, meet. Let me first of all extend once again a profound sense of grief and sorrow to the many thousands of families who have lost their loved ones over the past year to the pandemic.
Okay.
Their pain and anguish is our pain and anguish. And let me also reiterate our deepest sense of gratitude and support for the frontline health workers and the medical fraternity who have been rendering phenomenal service in the face of the severest of pressures and risks. We salute their sense of duty and dedication. Recently, I had a detailed discussion with our chief ministers and some ministers who belong to Alliance government. But what transpired was the gross unpreparedness and avoidable anarchism on the part of the Modi government in foreseeing, evaluating, and managing the crisis. Some of our chief ministers told me that they were left with just a few days of vaccines. They had no oxygen and they were running out of ventilators. But there has been a thundering silence on the part of government. On the contrary, some other states of interest to the BJP have been receiving preferential treatment in terms of equipment, etc. Instead of listening to the constructive suggestion of our party and other opposition leaders, some union ministers have been pressed into service to attack leaders of the opposition for giving suggestions. And it seems to me that this convoluted me versus you debate is completely childish and unnecessary. It is true that after months of denial, the central government has now given emergency use authorization for vaccines developed elsewhere. I suppose better late than never, but at what cost? India has already exported nearly 6.5 crore COVID-19 vaccine dosages to other countries. Considering the highest infection rate in the world in our own country, shouldn't vaccine export be held back and priority given to protect our citizens? Government must also reconsider its priority for vaccine candidates by reducing the immunization age to 25 years and above, as also to all younger persons with at-risk health disorders like asthma, angina, diabetes, kidney and liver diseases, and other similar ailments. In the course of my talk with our chief minister, the questions of GST came up. They felt that as a preliminary measure, all equipment, instruments, medicines, and support required to prevent and treat COVID-19 should be made free from GST. It is a matter of great concern that life-saving drugs like remdesivir etc., and medical oxygen, as also other basic supplements, are subjected to GST at 12%. Even basic equipments like oximeters and life-saving critical equipment like ventilators are subjected to 20% GST. In the current state of affairs, this is inhuman and untenable. As the central and state governments move ahead to control the situation by resorting to partial curfews, travel restrictions, closures, and lockdowns, we will be again restricting economic activity that will hit the already beleaguered people, especially the poor and the daily wagers. It is therefore imperative to provide monthly income support and transfer an amount of 6,000 rupees in every eligible citizen's account. We have made this request to government earlier on. Similarly, with reverse migration of labor already having started, it will be critical to immediately address their need of safe transportation, as indeed their suitable rehabilitation in host as well as home states. So let us ensure that these suggestions and other suggestions that you will be making, let us hope and ensure at least that the Modi government will listen to them or take them or some of them into account in the true spirit of democratic tradition.